Hey everyone, Run5F1. Today we have a Samson run, because we still have some stuff to unlock for Samson, and this is the reason we pick up this bad boy, but not in the Curse of the Labyrinth. Why, gamer, why do you always want to give me this Curse of the Labyrinth? This is not what I desire, this is not what makes for a good game. So we see what we have in this first item room, after we destroy this weird popcorn guy. And hopefully it will be something good, but it will be something horrible instead. We take it. This is the monster manual. And the monster manual, of course, gives you the ability to spawn a random familiar, which is very, very bad, but we take it anyway. I have no desire to go on restarting the game every 5 seconds. So this is what we do. We get ourselves a nice little familiar whenever we need to, which might be never. But yeah, let me just check my stuff and then we're off to go. The reason, of course, why we take Samson is we still need a bloody penny. And Samson is the only guy that can unlock the bloody penny, which is the only reason you really want to play Samson. Samson is so bad. Samson is so terrible. But anyway, let's just keep looking. Let's just keep hoping that we find something better. He starts off with a spirit heart, which is really nice. But he doesn't have that many advantages. In fact, he starts off with a special item, which means that he is less likely to get special items, which is bad. There are many special items that are really good, and you usually don't want many special items. So him starting off with already having a special item, not that great, honestly. But yeah, finding good items could make up for it all. Finding some good items could actually help you to win the game quite handily, if you get a knife, if you get some nice brimstone polyphemus action. All of this would be really great. And let's see what the secret room has in store for us. It's some money. Now we are at 7 cents. 7 cents, not bad, but also not hugely great. What we really need, of course, are some keys. I'm really the key fetishist here. And some good items. And we get the key. We are 9 cents. 9 cents, not bad, not bad at all. And we have Double Monstro. Double Monstro should count like the normal Monstro towards giving us the Monstro 2 later, which is not that bad of a deal because Monstro 2 is a freaking easy boss. There are so many worse bosses. Monstro and Monstro 2, very thankful enemies, not very threatening. And yeah, they don't even have that much health, so quite easy to take them both down. And right now we have our little demon baby. Demon baby shooting homing tears, I think. Or at least shooting always in the direction of the enemy, so kind of homing. Familiar is kind of homing. But still, that makes me not. That still doesn't make me really like the book, the monster manual. Monster manual is quite terrible. Like to get rid of it as soon as we can, like to change it for something else. So we got a key here, probably we'll liberate this later. And now we have lots and lots of these guys here. These guys, not difficult enemies. I could take some damage because of stupidity, but I probably won't. Look at their low fire rate. So this is how the Binding of Isaac works. You for yourself don't want high fire rate, and for the enemies you all have high shot speed. And for the enemies, you also don't want high shot speed. High shot speed makes them more difficult. If you have enemies like, for example, Conquest, then you will certainly realize that high shot speed makes them more difficult to dodge, and therefore makes it harder for you to actually not get hit. So this room is annoying. These hoppers, when they touch the fire, they become flaming hoppers, and the flaming hoppers are really not fun to deal with. The flaming hoppers really are a bad time, mean bad time for you. And I get hit here, really annoying. Get 2 bombs. And yeah, maybe Spirit Heart could have been hiding in this fire. So why not? Let's open this up and keep our fingers crossed. Maybe a tarot card for Judgment, a beggar, and a really powerful item. But it hasn't been this way. So let's keep our fingers crossed again. For a boss fight, for some very, very powerful devil rooms, for a pentagram, and yeah, we get a spirit heart if we defeat him, which should be quite easy, so this is good. And there's room layout, also very good. We have these poops here, which can be destroyed easily, and then only one row of rocks. So usually when you fight this kind of enemy you get more rocks, and this is really really inconvenient. But if you have only this 2, 6, 8 rocks and some poop, this is really a lot easier. If you, the more, the rule is, if you fight these snake guys, the more freedom of movement you have, the more difficult it is for them to hit you. They don't really track you down. Their movement is ordered by the RNG, random number generation module. So there is actually, should be no way you get hit if you have lots and lots of freedom to move. And I have lots and lots of freedom to move right now. I shot enough poops and I split him in half and killed this guy. And we get a speed up, which is really, really shabby, but don't like it. What do we have in the devil room? Yeah. Nonsense, pretty much nonsense. I will probably take the cat and then take the Book of Sins. I just hate the monster manual and I want to get rid of it. I want to get rid of it as quickly as possible. So I will actually move around a little bit. And then, yeah, thinking a little bit still. But let's just do it this way. Take the cat, take the Book of Sin, activate it, and get a sword. Yes, this is the start I was hoping for. This is actually a start that I wanted to see. So probably will not take this speed up. This speed up is not what makes me happy. This speed up is not what I was wishing for. I was wishing for a pentagram, or at least some kind of status upgrade. Maybe even a box, maybe something of that sort, but this belt is just not doing it for me. This belt is not 10 out of 10 would recommend. No, it is. It is like 3 out of 10 or 2 out of 10 would not recommend to a friend, really. Maybe a friend who is not really my friend, but somebody I don't like, would use that belt and slap that guy on the cheek or on the back of the head, maybe. So we have this room, this is really annoying, with more hoppers running right into my face, doing lots of damage, being generally annoying. And we have a second hopper, yes, second guy burning, and this guy's also starting to burn. There's still no real consensus whether or not these hopping guys actively seek the fire, or if it's just random how fast they jump into the fire. My own opinion subject is, I don't like hoppers and I don't want to think about it anymore. And maybe I should think about it more or pay more attention to them, because I have been hit 2 times by these assholes. Last one, and he hits me again. 3 ticks by these hoppers. This is just embarrassing. This is just another level of bad by me. So, apologize. So, more hoppers. Yes, but no fire in this room. This is actually some sort of relief. Yes, this is some sort of relief. And yeah, this guy, you need to die, bro. You just need to go. We have some bombs here. Very nice. Here's the item room. Very good. One dead, actually. And we have a challenge room, but I'm not very convinced that there's something in it. It's a normal challenge room, not a boss challenge room. So there will probably not be an item available inside. There will just be some great chests, and those great chests usually not that exciting unless you're really, really desperate for something. And it's a golden chest. In my opinion, in this situation, the golden chest is even less enticing. I only have 2 keys and I don't want to waste them. But let's see here what the secret room has. Even more money. Money is good. Now we have enough money to go to the shop. But first of all, let's go here. I'm peeing on the ground because I have no red hearts. And I'm peeing on the ground even harder right now with this lemon mishap. This is really not a good thing to have. So yeah, pretty bad stuff. So we go on right now and we hopefully have more luck on future floors with respect to the items we get. Oh man, hopefully the shop has like most amazing stuff, like a candle or a habit. Habit would actually be really powerful right now. And he has a compass. Compass is quite nice. It helps you to avoid trouble a lot. Helps you to optimize rerolls if you have to do 6. But right now, I'm just thinking, man, where is my powerful damage output? Where is the powerful stuff that helps me to actually wreck faces? I'm not seeing it right now, and I hope I will see it someday in the future. Or some room in the future. Still not gonna take the belt. Still not what makes me hot. Still not really turning on the thing. I'm thinking what I should be doing in this floor, on the floor, but there's nothing. So we go on. We go on our way, and we directly see where the item room is, but we don't have any key. And not having a key, but seeing the item room, there's always a hope game. A game where you say to yourself, well, I will probably get a key drop. I will probably get it. It's not that uncommon. So I help myself raise my own hopes up. But yeah, that's not guaranteed. And hopefully we get the key, and hopefully we will get a very, very, very powerful item that makes up for the utter crap we have seen right now. So Book of Sins is ready and gives us the Devil. Devil actually not bad. More damage, but only for one room. That's the one thing that annoys me about the Devil cards and about the Book of Belial. It gives you more damage, but only for one room, and it has quite a long time before it's charged up again. So it's not that reliable. It is almost like Bloody Lust. It is very situational, so I'm not the hugest fan. I like stuff that give you damage and keep the damage up. And I did not get a key drop before this room. So I have to continue searching, have to continue hoping, have to continue clutching at the vision of finding yet another shiny little key for the item room. And inside of the item room, hopefully something very powerful. I would take Mount Knife right now. I'm so underpowered. I get 2 bombs. More, and yeah. There could be a key inside this gray chest, but first of all, let us look through the rest of the floor. I don't necessarily want to fight for it if I don't need this gray box. So let's just keep on looking. We have these two popcorn guys. These two popcorn guys, of course, not very difficult. They themselves, even if you run into them, they don't deal any contact damage themselves. They are just dead, harmless and dead. But they spit flies at you. And for some reason, the physics in the Binding of Isaac work so that flies can actually hurt you, which is very ridiculous. But this is how the game works, and this is how we have to play it, because we don't want to get raped by flies. I remember before I heard Busy Snappy and other people like Northern Line, but mainly Busy Snappy, because Busy Snappy probably taught me the most about Binding of Isaac. Before I saw Busy Snappy using the trick that you can stand at the very top of a level and most flies won't reach you, I regularly got raped and gangbanged by flies. Regularly, you go into a room, you know these rooms, and the room is completely empty except for like 10 flies. Some of them double flies, some of them these red attack flies, and they all gang up on you and you take so much damage. These, if you have several flies that don't die once they hit you, just touch you, you just get pushed into some corner and you take so much damage. But when you notice that by just going into the very top part of the room and just pressing against the top wall, they can hit you. It's really so much easier. It's not even comparable. It's a different world of fighting flies. Of course, Binding of Isaac has many such exploits where you can go to certain parts of the screen and certain things won't hit you. Like, for example, if you fight Conquest, you can go to one of the doors and those big balls of light that also are used by Isaac and Blue Baby also can hit you. So these Globins are a bit faster than normal Globins. They have this eye. This is why they are called gazing Globins. The gazing Globins can actually see you. This makes them faster. And yeah, but once you have killed two of them, they are not that bad. So I get rid of this, get no drop. Boo! This is the worst room that does not even gives you annoying enemies, but no drops. And it gives me an annoying boss. It's a champion boss, so I will use the Devil. This guy is annoying. I will use several bombs on him. I don't even care. I am not a fan of fighting Peep. There are some bosses that I enjoy fighting. There are some bosses that actually give me some pleasure fighting them, but Peep is not one of them. Peep is one of those guys that is just annoying, that is just urinating all over the floor, that is just inconveniencing you every possibility he has. This is why we are using lots of bombs, and this is how I am going to play this. I have placed yet another bomb. The nice thing about Peep is, even if he jumps right on top of your bomb or right at the side of your bomb, and would actually realistically squeeze the bomb away and make it roll to a different place. It doesn't. The bomb somehow becomes sticky and keeps close to him. We get a tears up, wire coat hanger. According to many other players, wire coat hanger actually not that bad of an item. It gives you more, a higher fire rate. But I would have preferred, of course, the good old pentagram, which I'm not sure I'm very realistically getting right now. But who cares, I want damage. I want something that gives me a greater ability, even with brimstone right now. Although I have very low base ability to hurt enemies, brimstone alone would be nice. I would be using the brim snapping glitch. Of course, brim snapping after busy snappy. It means that you shoot a brimstone laser, but keep on tapping after you have released it, which means that you can hit up to 4 or 5 times and do more damage. It is really, really good. It is your only hope. If you have a combination like brimstone polyphemus, then it doesn't even really matter. Brimstone polyphemus does so much damage. Brimstone polyphemus just wrecks and destroys everything, absolutely everything. All the bosses die so quickly. So then it's not even such an issue. But if you have lower damage and if you then have brimstone, using brimstone with low damage without using the busy snappy glitch, that's just horrible. That's even worse than having tears. It's so pitiful. If you are this demon child and you charge your laser and you shoot this huge fountain of blood at these enemies, and then they don't even take a smidgen of damage, it's really depressing. So hopefully we'll get brimstone and some nice ways to amplify our brimstone damage. I would maybe even consider taking a mutant spider, although most of the time I don't like mutant spider as it completely ruins or mostly ruins your polyphemus. You would still, if you're in a situation, okay, this helps us to manipulate one of the rooms down there. If you are in a situation where you already have the mutant spider and you have brimstone, then it's still good. You should still pick up polyphemus, but it's just a +5 damage up. If you're in a situation where you have already picked up polyphemus and brimstone, then you should not pick up mutant spider, as with the brimstone and polyphemus without the mutant spider, you will do massive multiplied damage and should never take up the quad shard or mutant spider or whatever you want to call that item at this situation. So we will put the Book of Shadows back down. Some people might hate me for this, but I like my Book of Sins. I like my Book of Sins and I cannot lie. So I will pick it up and keep using it, although most people will hate me for this. And this is what I'm doing. You can't make me do different. And yeah, we should be done with this floor the way it looks. We have only 3 bombs left and we haven't found a secret room. And I'm actually sick of looking for it. I'm actually sick. I actually have no more interest in looking for the secret room. And I'm just curious and excited to see what's on the next floor. So hopefully no Curse of Darkness. And we get no Curse of Darkness. And we of course get an arcade, which means that the Book of Shadows would have been really, really good. It would have been really good. But don't get your hopes up if you are an arcade freak. I am cutting out the arcade parts. When I get to the arcade, I will actually cut it out, because gambling is just taking too long. The videos are already getting so long. So when I go into an arcade, at least in this version, until I get a better computer that displays the game faster, I will cut them out completely. And if you don't like it, you might leave an angry comment. I might reconsider it. But for now, I will cut them out. So deal with it. And yeah. This room pretty disgusting, full of poop, full of blood. There's almost no way this room could get more disgusting unless there was, you know who was would be here, you know who would make this room more disgusting, but this person is not here. So we might be thankful for this. No drop at the end. Freaking annoying. And let's go on. Yeah, this knight. This knight can't do jack to us. Always also really annoying. If you fight those knights for the first time and you don't know that you can hit them from the side most of the times. And here I will take stupid damage. The Robin's taking stupid damage and it's not good, and I only get 2 of these guys with my bomb. But who cares? Let's go on. Let's go on killing these guys. Let's go on with our silkworm hunt. Right now, I'm really hoping for something powerful. I'm really sick of being so underpowered, sick of being so limited in the way we can deal damage. And we get number one. Oh my goodness, the badness. Oh my goodness, the badness. Seriously. It's seriously time that we start to unlock some more powerful items. This run we will try to unlock the Bloody Penny. But in future runs we will try to unlock the Halo, which is damage up. And this is why I want the Halo. So this guy can't hurt me. Can't touch this. Can't touch this. And can't touch this. You're dead. You're dead, bro. You're dead. Okay, this guy goes down as well. And you go down as well. You go down as well after the first guy. Du bist am Ende. Dich mach ich kaputt. Jawohl. Jawohl, du kriegst es. Okay. So we will curse this guy in German and then we will actually destroy him. And man, he takes so much damage, or is it just me? I know I'm complaining a lot about my damage, but this is really, really annoying. Low damage runs are the worst, as I already said. Low damage runs. And we get a red heart, which is totally useless, or mostly useless. Yes, yes, oh no, oh yes, yes. Of course I will fight. Of course I will not leave a room with meat inside it, even if it means having to activate this trap and fighting these bosses. Meat actually means a 0.3 damage up and gives you more health, so it is really nice. And here's another monstro, so many monstros. I have no idea if fight killing monsters several times also, this also increases the chance of getting a monster 2 in later floors, it might be. So technically, theoretically, after killing this guy, I have killed monstro 3 times already. I have the first boss was a monstro. He was a champion version, so there are 2 small monstros, and I fought this monstro. So I have no idea how much. Oh, this was such a stupid bit of damage, seriously. But anyway, what I was saying is, I have no idea if I have +1, +2, or +3 chance increase for fighting a monster 2. But it's quite likely that I will fight a monster 2 in the future, which might be bad. It might be really bad. Not in the near future. So if I fight him like a normal boss, they would not be so bad. Fighting one monster 2 is not so bad, but in the chest, you can get double monstro rooms. And I'm pretty certain that killing several monstro ones will not only increase your normal, I got monstro 2 as a normal enemy or a boss enemy chances, but it will also increase the chance that you will get a double monstro room later. And double monstro room is the hardest room in the game. If you ask me what the hardest room is, apart from the room where you fight Conquest and at the start of the Conquest fight, it should be the Monster 2 room. These guys are just so evil. Usually, if you don't have a certain setup, if you don't have either amazing damage or if you don't have Cupid's Arrow, you cannot keep them both synced up, which means that they will jump around and generate millions and billions of enemies and it will just be a bad time. I am thinking that in Rebirth, if Edmund keeps the double monster rooms, they will actually get worse. In Wrath of the Lamb, actually, the amount of enemies that can be spawned anytime is quite limited. Oh, a golden key, nice. We'll use it directly. But the reason is the resources in Wrath of the Lamb, the game is not coded very efficiently. This means that you can't have so many enemies on the screen at the same time. So you actually need to limit the amount of spawns that can happen. So if you're Guppy and there are many enemies on screen already, you will not spawn as many flies, which is quite a pity. But on the bright side, if you're fighting monstro cannot spawn that many enemies as well. So in the Wrath of the Lamb, the double monster room, if it still exists, which it might, it should get a lot worse. It should get a whole lot worse. And just imagine a situation where you have one of these great rooms. So one of those rebirth rooms that are just 4 times as big as the usual rooms. And you get 2 monstros in this room. There's no telling how many enemies they could spawn. They could spawn hundreds and hundreds of flies. And they could actually drive you into a corner if you have low damage such as I have now. they could really cause you to just lose the game all by themselves, which is nice. We always want some unfair challenges, because unfair challenges make up for all of our advantages that we get once we learn the game better. And although I have learned the game quite well, I'm still doing stupid mistakes. I'm still committing stupid mistakes, still taking stupid damage just right there. This room, actually not as bad. You should not take damage in this room. This should not be what you are doing. So just be careful. Be careful. Be careful when you dodge. Be careful when you go up. Be careful when you go down. And yeah, just don't get hit. That's the best advice one can give. Running either, don't get hit. Play your adventures carefully. Hunt for the items that give you more power, that give you more defense, and also give you more offense. But don't get hit. Don't allow those freaking bastard enemies to take your hearts away from you. This is not what you want, and this is not what makes you happy. So we are here now in the arcade, and this might take a longer time, so I might be tempted to cut it out. So I will not bore you too much with it, and I cut it out. Found a blood bag, found some more keys, and I have now at 5 cents, which means I can still buy the spirit heart. If you like gambling a lot, then you'll have to wait until I get a better computer, which runs the game faster, as I already said, so I don't always generate like 1.5 hour runs with normal runs. But until then, I will try to cut out those long passages, which would just cause this game to go even longer. A normal run should be 43 minutes, normal business run is about 30 to 40 to 50 minutes, somewhat around there, but 43 minutes should be about a normal thing. If the game runs very good on your computer, which it does not on mine, but this is not what we should be crying about right now. We should be now concentrating on not getting hit, and this was actually quite dangerous, so I should complain less and concentrate more. This is generally a good thing, a good life advice. Complain less and concentrate more, although sometimes of course complaining is just what you're after. So I'm not a really freaking, there are people who really really get angry about complainers. There's this person who says, oh, XY, that doesn't work, and you get, and this person gets really really angry at them and says, no, you shouldn't complain, you should do XY that instead. But well, what can you do? So this enemy will give us a cube of meat. Cube of meat is of course this orbital that blocks tears and deals damage. It's, yeah, how do I feel about a cube of meat? We want one at least. Or rather say, we would rather have like a guardian angel and two pretty flies, that would be even better. But in a situation like I am in, where you have no orbitals, and you have no, oh my goodness, so much stupid damage, where you have no orbitals, and where you have actually no guarantee that you will get more orbitals anyway later. Where, why am I taking this damage? It's really weird. I'm really a bit confused right now. But having one orbital is a lot better than having no orbital. Orbitals can oftentimes save your life. So I want to take this and go into the devil room. And we find our second guppy piece, which I will probably take. I'm very confident that the Book of Things will give us more keys. And hopefully the guppy's tail modifier, which creates more gold, which causes more gold chests to spawn, will actually help us to get good items. This is not something that I can actively influence. I have no real guarantee that this will work out for us, but it might. This is the thing with the Binding of Isaac. Unless you are already crazy overpowered, there's no real guarantee that you're having that you will have a successful time. It is just you hope to get good items, and if you don't get good items, if you play the game as good as you can and then you don't get any good items, it's not your fault, it's the game's fault. And this is what Binding of Isaac is all about, hoping, and sometimes hoping and being and not getting what you wish for. Sometimes you are disappointed, sometimes you are positively surprised, sometimes negatively surprised. This is what the game is. It is the way the game was programmed, and this is the way we have to play it. So these two guys, this one guy almost hit me, but he didn't. I have the golden key, so it makes no sense not to open these chests. And yeah, another pill. I don't want to risk pills. Honestly, I don't want health down or Tears Down or Range Down. Something like these pills, Health Down, Tears Down, Range Down, would make me really, really, would really annoy me right now. I don't want it right now, and I will just keep taking this one pill with me, but not opening it. And we're going to fight Envy. Envy, of course, very interesting boss, splits up. Envy is, let's look at something for a second. Let's look at how this is going. Okay. So, Envy is the symbol, is what it says. This is the personification of the sin of being envious of other people. And this is the reason it splits up into many different faces. It is, if you are envious, then there's always somebody else in your life, or yeah, in your life, or somebody you watch a lot, or somebody that you pay a lot of attention to, and this person is in some way better than you, or in some way makes you envious. So this is what envy is. You concentrate on other people instead of yourself, and this causes in this way a lot of problems. It fills up the whole room with these envy faces, and this is what might deal damage to you. You always should try to keep the number of envy faces down. And normally, if you kill the blue envy guy last, it should drop an attack fly. And for some reason, it doesn't. Normally, the rule is it drops Shoot the Hoop if you kill a normal envy face last. But normally, if you kill this champion blue version last, then it should give you Shoot the Hoop. But it didn't, so no idea. I don't know anymore. Pretty weird stuff. Yeah, we give him our last cent. And do we get anything for it? Well, we get two more keys. Nice. I like the keys. I have no bombs, so I can blow these two things up. And yeah, we still have no real offensive powers. But we have still have our 9 lives, did not lose any lives. We have 2 spirit hearts and active, or 2 soul hearts and active soul heart regeneration in some limited fashion. So yeah, I'm excited to see what the next floor brings us. And it directly, yeah, interesting layout. So hopefully I can make it to the boss, not take any red heart damage, so it doesn't remove or deal with the devil chance. And get something really powerful. I would still take Mom's Knife. I'm still open to it, and I take really stupid damage. My goodness. My goodness. What is going on? What is going on for real? These brains, usually not very bad, but if you have low damage, they are really bad, and they are closing in on me. Please, please don't hurt me. Please don't do it. Uh-oh, I am captured. I am enslaved by these brains. These brains are too smart for me. They are superior. Approach stuff and leave stuff on the ground. Tactic is just too smart for me, and I have to deal with that. And we get a Mitre. Mitre is actually extremely powerful. Drastically increase the odds of that a randomly dropped heart would be so hard. But it does not solve our basic problem. Our basic problem was not that we did not generate enough defensive capabilities, as we have the dead cat. Our real problem was that we had not enough offensive powers, and this is not amended and helped by the might at all. Not at all, really. So these guys should be easy. Maybe even get some cube of meat damage in to kill them off faster. They are not, there's also a version of these red blobs that walk, and they are much worse because they have very, very good aim. But yeah, and what do we see? Yeah, we see Monstro 2. As was really predictable, we killed a lot of Monstros, and this, as I said, modifies the chance for a Monstro 2 appearing. So hopefully it will, this Monstro will be it, and there will be no double Monstro rooms later. Which are, as I said, double monster rooms, worst room in the game. But if you only have one monster room, one monster in the room, whether it be a boss room or a normal room, anywhere, then it is free. This is the big irony about Monster 2. If you have only one Monster 2 in the room, he is free. No matter how bad your setup is, no matter how weak your build is, you can just run up to him, make him charge his laser, and while he's charging his laser, while he's shooting his laser, walk to the other side and make him charge his laser again. And through this simple mechanic, keep him locked and keep him damaged without him having any chance of damaging you. But if you later in the chest encounter these guys, encounter two of these guys, it is very difficult. you will get them out of sync. At first you might get both of them to shoot their lasers, but one of them will get out of sync, will start jumping around, spawning monsters, and then both of them are out of sync, and then you're in a lot of trouble. I still have not figured out any good strategy, so if I have this amount of this weak amount of damage and then encounter these guys in the chest, I will be pretty much screwed. So hopefully we'll get some powerful items and this will not be a concern of others. I will leave this spirit heart laying here on the floor. I will save it up. I might take some damage on this floor, and I'm quite confident that I won't die on two red hearts on the rest of this floor, but I'm not too confident that I will be able to keep this spirit heart, so I will leave it there. I don't want to waste it. Spirit hearts are very useful and very precious, even though now we have the Midas, so we might see a lot more of them than we would normally expect to see. The Midas may increase the percentual chance that the randomly dropped heart will be a spirit heart, but it's not a guarantee. You can still be very unlucky and still get lots and lots of useless hearts but no spirit hearts. So this is something to consider. There's the RNG god is always there. Even if you play Isaac and you have the D6, you will still get into situations where you get bad items. You can have tons and tons of rerolls and still get only bad items. It has all happened. Sometimes the game just doesn't like you and sometimes it likes you. So we have two spirit hearts now on the floor that we should really try to remember. That we should really try not to forget when we leave this floor, because it would be a big waste. This guy going down easily, not getting hit by these things. Yeah, we should check out the secret part. Might even consider a fetus item, a doctor fetus or epic fetus. And we get this thing, not very exciting. Blow it up. And not getting any money, but yeah, getting a key and a bomb, so it was kind of worth it. These guys, the normal version. There's also the version of these vizzes, or how they are called, that shoots in two directions, but it is, oh my goodness, it was bad. But there's a version of this enemy that shoots lasers in two directions, out of their mouth, or whatever this is, and out of their behind, but for some programming reasons, only one of the sides does damage, and the side that does damage is determined randomly, so it's very curious and very, very weird in general. Yeah, I need more health, otherwise this challenge room won't open. There are of course two versions of challenge rooms. One version that is a normal challenge room that only opens up if all of the red hearts that you have are filled or you have no red hearts, like the baby. Or the version where you have the boss challenge room and you can't enter it unless you, if you have more than one filled red heart. So this means, or you, if you have no red hearts at all. So this means that Blue Baby will always find all the challenge rooms opened, which is one of the reasons Blue Baby is actually not that bad. Even though it is very difficult to keep Blue Baby alive. If you have a Blue Baby run and you don't get any Mitre or any solar generation like the Relic or Book of Revelations or the Nail, then you are actually in really big trouble. Or of course the Crystal Ball. With Blue Baby, if you don't have solar generation, you find yourself in very big trouble very quickly. There's no way that Blue Baby can take red hearts. So if you don't get lots of soul hearts, you're dead, quite literally. And I use this room and I get an item, but it's Tammy's head. If this had been a good item, this might have really saved the run. But I use the fact that this room has to pay out to you if this room, by hurting you, puts you down to a half red heart. Which is kind of nice. I think it also works in a situation where you have half red hearts, only one half red heart, and the rest is just lots and lots of soul hearts. But I don't know. I have not been in this situation yet. And I get the full damage again, my full health back, so I can go to the challenge room, which hopefully gives me the money to go to the shop. I would really hope for something really good. As I said already, Nun's Habit would be really, really good, really powerful, would make me really happy. And we go down, finding ourselves in a situation where we have this gray chest. Do I want this gray chest? Actually, I don't want it. I even want to fight for it. And we have now three spirit hearts lying on the, or three soul hearts lying on the floor. Nice, nice, but I still won't take it. I still am not sure if positive if I can survive this floor without taking soul heart damage, so I will just leave it there. I'm confident that I can survive on just two red hearts. We are just in the death 2, which means that damage, most enemies will only do 1 heart of damage. Once we survived or completed the mom fight, we will be in a situation where any enemy will always do 1 full heart of damage unless we get the wafer. And then, since we don't have the wafer and I don't really expect or plan on getting the wafer right now, we will have a lot, we would be in a lot worse or in a lot more dangerous situation with just 2 red hearts and nothing else. But as is right now, I'm quite comfortable leaving the three soul hearts on the ground and continuing this way, finishing this floor with just 2 red hearts available to us. So just 3 more unexplored rooms left for us. This should be quite doable with our health situation. And what does this room hold so far? It's a lot of flies, and I think I will take them. Stupid damage. These flies, individually, they are really weak, but so many of them, it's actually annoying. And here's the stupid damage that I promised to take. Yes, but please no more. And this guy is dead. Now they're almost all dead. This guy takes more damage, he's gone, gives us even more spirit hearts, really nice, thank you Mitre. And what do we have here? Oh, lots of globins and even 2 gazing globins. Disgusting enemy, and if you're new to the Binding Isle, it's actually quite difficult to handle. But the way it is now, I will just use some bombs, destroy these guys, and remember, if you manage to get them down once, even if they recover themselves and go back to humanoid form, they will still be a lot easier to take down. Once they are taken down once, it takes a lot less damage to take them down another time. And this was probably made in order to prevent low damage builds from being stuck. If the globins would all take full damage, even if they after they have been taken down once, to be taken down the second and subsequent times, that might be easily possible to get stuck on a low damage build. There are situations, for example, where attack number 1, which reduces your, as I've already told you, which reduces your range to minimum, to be in situations where you have an enemy that can only be reached with higher than minimum range, and then you're stuck. Congratulations. I did not take the steam sail. It's generally not worth to take the steam sail, of course. It is just quite a useless item, and it can come in handy if you later find a d6 and you later find more versions of greed and you kill those versions. And if you didn't pick up the steam sail, then the steam sail might appear later and you can reroll it, so you have to reroll it first too. The rule with items in Binding of Isaac is with many items they can reappear twice and many times over until you pick them up first and they can't appear anymore. This is the reason why in some runs people manage to get like 4 or 5 sacred hearts. They just keep rerolling stuff and using the d20 shenanigans to create a lot of sacred hearts, but they have to really make up their minds how many they want. Since at the moment, because once they start picking them up, there won't be any more sacred hearts, which is kind of sad. Really, this is some of the aspects that I don't like that much, but this is how the game is coded, so we'll have to play it as well. And we continue our encounter raid with globins. This time at least we have no gazing ones, this means we only have the slow kind of globin. And yeah, we see all the room layout and we see all the icon rooms. Of course, this is enabled by having the treasure map and having the compass, really nice. And yeah, definitely want to make a beeline towards the treasure room, or the item room, And hopefully we will finally get something that increases our power level. Our power level has been really bad, really pathetic. And yeah, just make some more adjustments and we should be able to finally get there. As I said, I'm hoping really for something that pushes us out here. Hopefully something that makes this run more powerful. Taking more stupid damage against these guys. Usually you shouldn't take damage against these guys, but this room is a bit impractical as there's so much blocking. You have really not that many places to go. The only way this room could be worse is if there were either masks or hearts. Masks or knights. And if there was a room where there were actually masks and knights combined, this would just be overkill. But with masks, this room is, if you don't have flying, this room is very brutal. And actually also a very difficult room not to take damage in. Not as hard maybe as the double monster room, but already very hard and very stupid. So yeah, we get even more keys. And we get another terrible item. So by now, the fact that we are so not so very well positioned in this run, it's really not my fault, honestly. It's really rather the game's fault, because it is giving me such terrible, terrible items. And there's really not that much that I can personally do about it. So we have this room, where we have even more brains. But luckily, these brains don't have the aid of obstructive rocks or ravines or holes in the ground that cause me to run right into their creep. This should be quite easily doable without taking any damage. And we might even get another spirit heart because of our mitre, but we don't. And there is this Book of Belial, but I'm not too sold on that. I'm really sticking to this. I'm waiting for a powerful, really powerful spacebar item, because I'm still having some kind of hope that we will get the habit or something, and that this will push us over the top. Or that we will get the candle. At this point I might as well take the candle. My damage output is so low that I need something to complement my damage. And while the Book of Belial does that, it is arguably very situational. It can only be used every six or seven rooms, or every six rooms about. Which means that most of the time we will be without its uses, its damage bonus, if we decide to take it up. And I would much rather have something that gives me value all the time. So the Book of Sin gives me value all the time, as it gives me more keys. And another out that we have, another possibility of surviving this run and actually beating the final bosses, is that we are lucky enough to use our Guppy's Tail to generate a lot of items from that chest. And yeah, I have some way to exit this fight, and we are fighting Mum. And for some reason I have a terrible streak in the last games of fighting Mum. For some reason this fight is just cursed for me. So I'm expecting to take a lot of damage, I'm expecting to get really mauled, I'm expecting to get really bad enemies as I'm doing right now, these flies and these guys. If you are if you're fighting this boss, what you want is lots of enemies that don't chase you down. Lots of enemies that are just leaving you alone so you can park yourself directly at one of the doors, at the side of the doors, not in front of it, but the side, so that the foot can stomp at you. But right now I'm getting all the bad enemies that just hunt you down. So there's actually no sense in trying to cheese this boss. If you get three enemies that don't attack you or that don't hunt you down, maybe like a grandfather fly and some of the short range shooting mobs, not this mob, but the short range version, and then maybe another body that just runs around and doesn't chase you down, then it's good. But the enemy spawns right now are actually terrible. So yeah, I will take lots of damage. I have taken lots of damage, but hopefully I can somehow survive this. Now I even get a psychic maw, which is even worse. So you see that this thing shoots homing tears. It looks about the same as Isaac when he has the spoon bender, or when he has telepathy for dummies activated. But the difference is this enemy has much better homing. If the homing this guy had, if the homing that you get from items such as Spoon Bender or Telepathy for Dummies was as good, then maybe those items would actually be good and not be so terrible. But they are terrible, since when you get homing, your tiers only curve a little bit, they don't curve as much. So, no luck there. These two enemies are good. These two enemies are good, and they could allow me to cheese, and this one is not good enough. The positioning of this Grandfather 5 was not ideal. And yeah, but I'm a bit paranoid. Yeah, it spawns. This enemy is not good. This enemy up there is good, actually. But yes, I'm paranoid. I'm not confident in cheesing anymore. I've got during the last episode that I uploaded, I got hit even while I was in the cheese spot. So I have basically abandoned the idea for now of cheesing Mama. I'm just trying to avoid everything and not get hit. And yeah, hopefully survive this fight without taking even more damage. I've lost several spirit hearts, which is very hard. But yeah, but once again, the main reason that this is so bad is that we don't deal enough damage, and this means that the boss has lots of time to mess with us. If we had more powerful items, then we would be done already and we wouldn't have taken that many hits. We would just have gone through the boss's HP. As in many cases, in many games, offense is the best defense, and if in Isaac you can get a strong build with strong damage output, then this is one of the best ways to defend yourself. I might have the Mitre, and I might have the Book of Sins, and I might have 9 lives, but still, one of the best ways to protect yourself still in Binding of Isaac is having lots of damage outputs. So I get Squeezy. This kind of makes me stronger, as it increases my tiers output, but it's not as good as a straight damage up. So I'll take the Polaroid and teleport myself into the shop with the Hermit card. And we get these items. We could use the slot machine to try and beat this boss on this floor multiple times, but judging from the way it turned out the first time, I don't really want to do this. I don't want to lose even more spirit hearts, which might just cause me. Honestly, if I used the slot machine there and actually managed to spawn a black fly and to refight the boss, this might actually end up putting me into an unwinnable situation where I die and get respawned with 8 lives, only have one heart left, and then I'd be in a situation where I had no chance to beat the boss and be stuck on the floor and just die 7 more times, and that would not be what I am planning for. I'm planning to unlock the bloody penny. And in order to do that, we need to get a little bit further. So let's just leave the slot machine where it is. It wouldn't make any sense more right now buying it anymore, as we have spent our money on other things, which is good. We wanted those keys, and yeah, this key rather. And this guy is down, and use a bomb to get this spirit heart, which is very useful. I will take it right now. And there's our Chop Chop. This time, of course, with 3 bots. I think the only way you can get a buttless chop is if you spawn him down in the utero, or if he spawns rather down in the utero. You can see how long it takes me to take him down. I am a bullfighter right now. I have my red cloth, and I'm causing this guy and his little children to charge at me, but instead of letting him nom 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 me up, of gobbling me up, I will cause them to charge by and then slay him and hopefully get even more spirit hearts. The ideal scenario, of course, would be if this guy was dropping a tarot card, and this tarot card would turn out to be Judgment, which is of course a beggar, and then I would play this beggar and he would give me Mom's knife, and finally all my woes would end. But the Mitre right now doing work. This is another spirit heart. Hopefully I won't take damage, but yes, this was just not ideal for getting out. I don't know if a better player would have gotten out there without taking damage. Again, I blame it on my build, but it will just cost me one bomb to destroy this rock over there and get the spirit heart, and this will more than make up for the damage I've taken in this room. So then I will get this guy very carefully, don't want to get hit by him. And yes, his body is down and not a head will charge, but I have a longer range on him. So put a bomb here, put it directly in front. And yeah, this is randomly happens. Sometimes instead of building a bridge, that thing just explodes and doesn't build a bridge for you. This, as far as I know, happens completely randomly, and there's no way of preparing for that. There's no way to prevent that from happening. But it's just bad luck. This is just the game sticking its finger out to me. Thank you very much, RNG. Okay. Even more money, even more sadly. This heart also had a high chance of becoming a spirit heart. Thanks to the Mida, maybe even 50% around that. I do not want to fight the mini boss, have no interest in doing that. And we see if we are in the devil room. We did not. And yeah, what do we do now? We look a little bit to the sides and we look what we got here. We got more fly spawning things. And again, if you don't know that the flies can reach you to the very top of the level, most of the flies, then this room might actually be difficult. There's not much room, not much wiggle room, there's not much room for you. How did you get out? This is weird. Yeah, sometimes those enemies, sometimes enemies in general can just do weird stuff. Sometimes you can have like Larry Juniors, those big worms, and instead of going normal path, they go over rocks and it's really weird. But in this case, I think I did quite well. Yeah, but as I said, hopefully this is the last Gubby piece. No, it would have been worth it. If that was the last Gubby piece, I would have just about quadrupled my tripled my damage. Okay, now I fight him anyway, I'm in the mood. But very low chance that this guy will actually give me some freaking Guppy item. I need one more piece of Guppy. And once you're Guppy, you can fly, and each and every one of your tiers spawns a fly, which is very nice. Hopefully there's a Guppy item here. No, but a key. Okay. Who cares? I care. But when you're Guppy, each and every hit that you land on an enemy will actually spawn a kamikaze fly, and they will do twice your damage. So do the math. Before the Guppy transformation, you do your own damage, and after the Guppy transformation, each and every tier will spawn a fly that does twice your damage. So now you have three times the damage. And I will take some damage here, which is really stupid and annoying, but there's nothing I can do about it. And yeah, Guppy is really nice. Would help me a lot right now. In the community remix, there's also a transformation into Tammy. So when you do that, you instead of spawning flies, you will occasionally do the Tammy side effect, which is just shooting tears in all directions. Which is honestly not comparable to Guppy. Guppy is a lot stronger than Tammy, at least in the version of the community remix that I've seen. Maybe if the Tammy transformation or some other white cat transformation makes it over to Binding of Isaac Rebirth, that will be stronger, but right now Guppy is a lot stronger. And yeah, the thing is, before I really got into the whole Guppy thing and got really transformed into Guppy several times, I didn't know what the difference was between the Guppy effect and the Mulligan effect. The Mulligan effect is actually a lot worse than the Guppy effect. The Mulligan effect, if you pick up the Mulligan, you only have a certain chance of spawning a fly. And the chance is not that great, but when you are Guppy, then your chance is 100%, which means that every single fly that you spawn, every single tier that hits any enemy will immediately spawn a kamikaze fly, as long as there are not that many enemies in the room that actually enemy spawning is disabled, or creature spawning is disabled. Okay, what do I want to do with this thing? I just blow it up. You take it and get my bomb back, so why not? Still devil room, that's not opened, so we just go. So yeah, Guppy is very powerful. Guppy is especially powerful with Mom's Knife, of course. Mom's Knife. Oh, this does not look good. Hopefully the game does not crash or something. But yeah, if you have Guppy and you have Mom's Knife, this means that when you every single frame that your knife hits, you will spawn more flies. And I think you can even use that in combination with blue candles. So the blue candle thing is, and I don't know if this glitch is widely known, if you throw out the knife and then you have blue candle and you push space bar and you put blue candle over your head, you can hold blue candle. You can. Okay, now we have the curse of the labyrinth, which is not that nice. Then you can hold the blue candle steady over your head, which is normal. But as long as you hold blue candle this way, if you don't put it down, then mom's knife will actually hover in the air. And it will hover and it will remain inside an enemy. And it will continue doing damage, of course, which is kind of nice. I had several chances to experiment with it, but it didn't do... Yeah, it was nice, but it was not as nice as I had hoped it would be. For some reason, I don't really understand the mechanics behind it, but again, you heard it here, the glitch is when you have mom's knife, when you throw mom's knife and mom's knife is thrown, is flying through the air, and you have the candle in your spacebar slot, and you use it, and you don't fire the candle, but instead you tap the spacebar once and hold it, so that you hold the candle over your head. While you do this, the knife will not return to you, but instead keep hovering where it is. So you heard it here. Unless somebody else already discovered it, which is quite possible, but I don't know. So killing these lamps are really annoying, especially if you don't have a way to deal with them quickly. And we have another arcade, and we'll probably cut out the arcade again. This video is already quite long, and I don't want to make it extremely long. So I will cut out most of the things that are just made up of repetitiveness. These guys here, they all need to go, they all need to take it, they all need to get it and then get going into death. So I get this guy, hopefully. No, he's still alive, and now he's done. And this guy, and these lumps here, teleporting. In Rebirth there will also be some teleporting enemies, but they will be different. They will be, for example, worms and stuff. So yeah, they should make these ones a little bit easier, but therefore make those jumping ones that the jump and sometimes shoot these exploding things harder, because those are too weak and too easy. Okay, pushpin, really bad. Instead of using a sand, I can just use two bombs, it might be better. If I just go left and then go into the bloody, you know what? Into the bloody secret room, and through the secret room, of course, go into the arcade with another bomb. Should be fun. These guys, come on, why won't you die already, please? Please, I'm not asking much. I'm not asking for the world, I'm not asking for the stars in the sky, I'm asking for you to die. Oh, that thing rhymes. I'm not asking for the world, I'm not that bold. I'm not asking for the stars in the sky, I'm just asking for you to die, my dear lumps. Nobody wants you, you are itchy and you are annoying. So yeah, got a spirit heart, very nice. And yeah. Here we have little unicorn form, we will use it in the arcade to abuse it a bit. And use a bomb to go in here. Boomy boomy, open it up. And yeah, we did a lot of gambling. We got a lot of soul hearts from this fortune teller machine. Unfortunately, I screwed up my half heart interval. That means that we need to keep looking for one, which is really stupid by me. I apologize. And I will keep this blood donation thingy, this IV bag. I need it. I am really dependent on Polaroid invincibility. And as you can see, I'm really not good at keeping Polaroid invincibility. I need a way to re-get my Polaroid invincibility. So yeah, this is what I need. Hopefully we will find a half heart soon, so that I will be able to pick up the half heart and use this thing once. In this case, I'm only almost using it like a guppy's paw. But right now I have no Polaroid invincibility, which is really sucky. Since if I had paid a little bit more attention, I could have gotten more. The reason I don't have more money is, for some some weird reason on my computer the glitch doesn't work. So normally, if you run the game normally, you can use the blood bag to hurt yourself once and then go back and forth between two rooms and generate as much money as you want. For some reason my computer won't let me do that. For some reason I cannot use this item. Maybe there has been a patch, maybe this glitch has been patched, or maybe it's just that my computer is not good enough to somehow display the whole thing and I will take damage here. Which is very unfortunate. Yeah, at least get this guy down. And get his brain down and take even more damage, which is really not nice. More spirit hearts, but I want one half heart pretty desperately right now. I want one half heart, but I have the feeling that now that the game knows, oh, this guy wants one half heart, it will troll me and not give me one. So yeah, let's continue with the stuff here. And right now, fighting all these weird cysty things, not that nice. I don't care that much about the jumping ones. They cannot really do you any harm. They can, but they are... It's pretty unlikely. They are very slow and they don't have any range attacks. But this guy is dead as well. I get the gold chest and get more spirit hearts, which is nice, but no half hearts right now. The Mida is kind of screwing me. It prevents the half hearts from spawning. Not very nice of you, Mida. Okay, at least let's let one half heart through so I get more pull-out invincibility. But at least I get spirit hearts. Spirit hearts are always good, I will not complain. Man, the thing is, when I was in the arcade, I always picked up the half hearts and then used my kind of overestimated my invincibility and then accidentally overdid it with the blood bag and then get one thing too much. It was really bad, and then the item gang gives you just one full red heart. It's really annoying. So I will bomb myself through here. Would just take too much time with my damage setup. And yes, bomb myself through here, take totally stupid damage. And yeah, at least only one damage. And this guy also gets skipped. Get skipped man. So these guys again, do I want to fight them? Good question. Very good question. You go down, please. And then this guy goes down. Yes, you go down, please. Come on. Yes, you can do it. My orders are doing work. Now, three more to go. Come on, you can do it. You can bite it. You can bite it. I believe in you. So this guy goes down as well. Now only one left. That shouldn't be too bad. And he goes down as well. No drop. And I have to fight this room. There's no choice about that. You cannot bump into boss rooms. You cannot ever use certain enemies to push you through boss room doors. You can have fighting Daddy Longlegs. And the long legs, when you are directly at the door, even if it's closed, if one of his legs hits you, then it can push you through doors. It can push you into deals with the devil. It can push you into boss rooms. It's very interesting. This enemy actually not as bad, but I will probably take several unnecessary hits since I messed up my own pull rod invincibility. Not that nice. And look how long it takes. So this thing should spawn some spiders. Once you kill the smallest part, these small parts, once you kill them, they should spawn spiders. And this is a very terrifying boss in a way. This teratoma is actually a medical disease. And just imagine you had some these kinds of growths at your inside or at your body with spiders in them. Not very pleasant sounding. But anyway, kill those spiders. And kill even more spiders, and now you can see I'm getting redder and redder. My rage is filling, but it's not that much damage and it's not that reliable. So only got hit once, so it was not as bad. Oh man, these items. It's not my fault the items are just terrible this run. So we will probably use lots of bombs against Mom's heart and still take a long time to kill her. Look at this, the time I need to even deal with these weak stupid laser eyes. Not that nice. Okay, now put down a bomb. And put down even more bombs for this guy to die. The monstro. Okay, and waste the bomb. Not that nice. And hit him again. Yes, I should get him in this phase. No, he decides to jump again, but now he's dead. No, that's another bomb. And it's perfectly timed. Get even more bombs, wasting even more bombs. And yeah, getting this bomb, placing this one down, getting hit in a stupid way. This guy dies, I waste this bomb. Why? These guys, they are too easy. They are, don't have enough health, usually. Okay, this guy just will go down easily. My bloody lust is already, should be maxed out about. At least now it should be maxed out. 25 bombs left, still lots of health to go. This chubby guy, he eats it. Eats a lot of things right now, and then he gets hit, and his friend gets destroyed, and he will get destroyed as well. And yeah, we have still quite some health to go, but we should be close to repeat bombs. We're now at repeat bombs, which means that now the heart will remain lowered the whole time, and we should be able to, yeah, to do this. We still have lots of spirit hearts, but we definitely want to find a half heart so that we can sacrifice this full red heart, get down to permanent full red invincibility, and be safer. We still have all of our guppy dead cat lives, but we're still missing one guppy piece, which is really annoying. If we had guppy right now, which could easily have happened. I've seen lots of deals with the devil, and I've been to several curse rooms. Then the whole thing would have been a lot better for us. We would be in a lot better situation. Or if one of the many items that was complete crap, we saw Lemon Mishap, we saw My Best Friend. We saw all kinds of stuff like this, and this is just not something to win run with. So, and since we don't have the D6 to reroll stuff, this is just what we were stuck with, and of course we didn't take Lemon Mishap, or for that matter. Of course I'm bombing here through because I'm expecting to get a very powerful item. Don't hit me, don't hit me. Thank you. And yes, these guys. Kill this thing. Yes, this is what I want. So I will take this and then use the blood bag once. And now I'm at full rod invincibility, and it even started right now. And now I will be careful not to take up any more half hearts. Or any more hearts at all. At any more hearts, period. So these guys. Bicycle helmets, usually not that bad. There are actually rooms in the cathedral where there are three bicycle helmets, and they are very scary. They tend to go into different directions, and then you have to deal with bicycle helmets coming at you from different angles and different directions, and it's just not really that much fun. So another key. And what do we get? We get a Book of Refs, which we will take. So now we have to be extra careful not to take any especially during the chest, we have to be extra careful. If we accidentally pick up any red hearts during this floor, it will not be as bad. We can go back and restore our poor invincibility. Although I will probably bomb through more rooms, so this will not be that great of a prospect. Yeah, and especially in the chest, we have to be very careful not to pick up red hearts. Since as long as we keep this situation and then use the Book of Revelations. Yeah, but you see, even picking up the Nun's Habit, I'm not very confident that I can win, by the way. But even things like the Nun's Habit would have made this run a lot more winnable. Nun's Habit, of course, would have been great already with the Book of Sins. But now with the Book of Revelations, it would have been downright broken and very good, as it would have been a wafer. And if we, let's say we had even more luck, if we found a wafer and the, and if we, by now we had found a wafer and Nun's Habit, we would have won. If you didn't know, if you have the wafer, and Nun's Habit. Can't bomb out of here. Sadly, the exit has vanished. Yeah, this is what I was talking about. These three bicycle helmet rooms, they are really bad if you don't have much killing power. Yeah, but if you didn't already know, if you have the Wafer, Nun's Habit, and anything that gives you health, like for example the Book of Revelations health on a dependable basis, then you're invulnerable. The situation is, let's say, you are at a chest, you have the Book of Revelations, you have the Wafer, and you have Nun's Habit. This means whenever you get hit, you only lose half a heart, which is of course the Wafer's doing. If you have the Wafer, you only lose half a heart, and you get half spirit heart back, basically, as your Book of Revelations is charged by half. So all you have to do is hit spacebar every two hits and get back the full amount of damage that you've taken. So even if you have minimal health, you will still be able to beat the game with the combination of a Wafer, Nun's Habit, and any reliable spacebar item like Young Heart or Book of Revelations, as the enemies will not be able to kill you, and you will be able to kill them eventually. So what we don't have it, we only have one third of it, and it's not realistic without a D6 to hope that we will get either Wafer or Nun's Habit, although both would be very, very powerful, of course. The Wafer basically doubles your health, which is in itself very, very... The Wafer is always powerful for any situation, basically. The Habit is only worth something if you have a good spacebar item. If you have a character and you don't start with a spacebar item and you don't have a spacebar item, then the Habit is just useless junk. But you should try to pick it up anyway, since there's always the chance if you pick up any kind of useful spacebar item later. Even the Book of Sins, even different stuff, for example, what are other nice spacebar items? Yeah, of course, the Crystal Ball is also very powerful with the Nun's Habit. There are many different ways. Even Mr. Mega could be argued is sometimes powerful, is at least not terrible with Nun's Habit. You get super bombs, and if you don't have Mr. Mega upgrade, or Mr. Boom rather, if you have Mr. Boom, it's still something that's useful with Nun's Habit, although not as useful as... Or, of course, if you have Book of Shadows, Book of Shadows with Nun's Habit is also pretty broken. If you have Book of Shadows with Nun's Habit, you have a very tough boss fight, a very tough room, you will very quickly get your 10 seconds of invincibility back, and 10 seconds of invincibility is a lot, and helps you out a lot, even with characters that don't have that much killing power. So be very careful, try not to take too much damage against Isaac. And I took damage already, so put down this bomb, put down another bomb, make this guy eat it, come on, eat it up. Eat up those bombs to your freaking Isaac face. Eat them bombs, eat them bombs, eat them, eat them, eat them bombs. Eat them bombs, Isaac. Eat them tears, Isaac. Eat them bombs, Isaac. Eat them tears, Isaac. And die from the cube of meat. Die from the cube of meat. Don't shoot at me, Isaac. Don't shoot at me, Isaac. Please, I'm just a little Isaac like yourself. I'm just a little Isaac slash Samson as yourself. Just a little Isaac slash Samson as yourself. Please don't shoot at me. Please don't shoot at me. Anyway, you can see this might take a while. I'm playing quite carefully. I only have one orbital, and I really cannot afford to just stand there and spam with tears. It's just not something that is strats for me right now. It's not strats, as Busy Snappy would say. But we are making some progress. Health is actually going down. And I'm almost doing this with base damage, with Samson base damage. Not that nice. But yeah. Hopefully we will be able to eventually go to the next phase, and then finally go to third phase, which should be the easiest if it were not for all those freaking angel fetuses, which I cannot deal efficiently with. he spawns a lot of angel fetuses, I'm actually in trouble. I will need to use most of the rest of my bones to somehow survive the third phase. It would take way too many tier hits if I just try to defend myself against the angelic babies or angelic fetuses or whatever you call them, these angel things that cry three tears at the same time. Okay, another bomb. Or not. Didn't want to come out. Fine with me. I need many bombs for the angelic baby phase anyway. And if you don't have enough firepower to kill the angelic babies quickly, then you, for this boss at least, you need to use bombs. This is the only way you can somehow keep the numbers down and keep them from totally raping you. So yeah, more than half damage. I've damaged him for more than half his own health, which is quite nice actually. So now I get him down even lower. And he should soon enter the third phase, which will trigger me to run around like an idiot, like a chicken with its head cut off, and place down a lot of bombs. Placing down the bombs will cause me to hopefully will cause most of the angelic babies to die. And this will hopefully enable me to defeat this boss without taking much more damage. So you see, these things don't home as much. There are various degrees of homing actually in this game. You remember when I was in a mount fight and this psychic moth started attacking me? That thing had a very strong degree of homing. The tears actually followed me around for quite a long time, but this is luckily not that much of a homing. The homing effect is not as strong. I wonder if in Rebirth they are this continuous and maybe is a bit extended so that even you as a player can get different levels of homing. And I'm quite certain that I saw already something along these lines, even something with homing and brimstone. It was quite nice. I hope this plays out the way I saw it in the promotional videos of Rebirth. And again, if you want to see all the videos and images and all the information about Rebirth that's already out, you just have to go to Google and put in Binding of Isaac Rebirth, and then you go to this Binding of Isaac page, and then they tell you a lot about it, and it's really nice. So hopefully it won't take more. Yes, took more damage. Really stupid. Come on, you freaking angelic babies. I don't want you in my life. Come on. And yay, we get the bloody penny. So we achieved what we set out to do. We have our bloody penny. And we are one step closer to becoming a platinum god, which is actually great. Hopefully the greatest items of all time. Okay. Okay. Not okay. Well, I think I'm pretty dead. Won't take these other things until I've died. And yes, I went into this direction because I want to see if there's maybe an epic fetus inside of the secret room. Hopefully there is. And this lust is actually causing a lot of trouble. Very troublesome deadly sin. This is why they're called deadly sins. They're called this way as reference to the deadliness. Close combat, for example, if you have to do with lust. And I get hit even more. Yes, yes, yes. Too nice. Too nice. Thank you very much. And there's lots of tears flying around, but now, yeah, kill your buddy. Now kill you. You will give me tons and tons of spirit hearts, hopefully. Come on, die, please. Please, come on, you can do it. I believe in you. Come on. Come on. Nishan Sulema. Nah? Yes. Okay. Two spirit hearts, take them. Bomb here. And we get money, yay, yay, money, yay. Okay, that was not really worth it at all. See what we got here. We got these asshole fires. I really hate these fires. I'm gonna dispose of all of them. They're really not nice. And what is this? Oh, it's just the hardest room in a chest with no damage. So this is what you get for killing several monstros in earlier floors. Or on earlier floors. This means that you get more monster tools. And yeah, how will I actually beat this room with the amount of damage I have? I have no idea. I'm actually at a loss of ideas. This fight is just a pain in the, you know what, this is just a pain, this fight. This is just painful. I mean, look at this, they are bouncing around everywhere. They are bouncing around everywhere, shooting their lasers, taking almost no damage from my puny little tears. This is just painful. If you think this is painful to watch, then just imagine how painful it is to play. Yes, I have 9 lives, but I will probably just die a lot of times at this room. Very nice prospect, very great. And again, it's not my fault, it's the game's fault. It did not give me good items, so what on earth am I supposed to do about it? Nothing. So yeah, 2 more hits and I'm dead. Very nice stuff, they are jumping all over the place. All over the place. And yeah, I got them both in the sink here. Come on. And yes, 1 more hit and that's it for this life. Come on guys, die please. Almost got you. Almost got you. Come on, die please. Die, 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 die. Come on. Oh no. So what do we do now? We need health in order to deal with them. And I don't think even with this health up I can deal with them. I don't think that's possible. I do not think that is possible. So what do we do? Well, we fight them again. Sadly, they don't damage each other. Which actually makes this the hardest room in the game. I'm almost dead again. So, but 4 hearts is not that much anyway. And yeah, almost dead. Just jumping on my head, you little ass. And I'm dead again. There was no chance really I could get out there, I think. So yeah, we're basically dead. Welcome to Afterlife. Take with a Bobby, because why not? Look at the other rooms. Maybe there's something that will actually help me survive. Maybe I find a mom's knife somewhere here. Or a rosary or something like that. But it looks like we are freaking dead. Interesting, we at least made it to the chest, which is really not that bad considering we had such a bad build and now we die here. Yeah, but it doesn't really matter where we die. If we die against those things, or against if we die against monster twos, or if we die against the bloat, I have no idea. I would rather die against monster twos. I find the bloat is a disgusting enemy, really disgusting guy. And another bloat, yeah, why not? Die against him sometimes. Just give me a chest, or just give me a chest and... or give me a tarot card, which is the beggar, and the beggar gives me mom's knife. And then another beggar card somehow that gives me a rosary. Yes. Yes, come on, poop all your blood. We don't care. We have nothing to lose, guys. We are a man with a mission that is doomed to fail. We are on a suicide mission. There's no way we're gonna finish this game in this way. There is actually no way. We got him down almost to 0 life. Bombed him a little bit more because why not? With this low amount of health, there's no chance of beating Blue Baby. No chance. So yeah. This seems to be quite a sad situation. What do you want to do? What do you want to do? I have so many lives, but without health and without damage, this makes no sense. This is actually just hilarious. Just laugh about it. Just have a little chuckle at how mean the game can sometimes be. And what's this? Beggar? No, it's the chariot. Chariot is actually really powerful. So this guy, he can just randomly hit you, so there's no way you can guarantee, even if you play perfectly, against this guy. Even this is one of the enemies, even the doors won't save you. So even if he does his certain attack where he keeps his face on the screen, but then lots of his feet come down at the same time, this is a random attack, and even if you are close to one of the doors, it can still hit you. This attack is good, this attack is well made, and you can dodge it, but the other attack is just freaking BS. The other attack, if it does it, I will probably just die and there's nothing. This attack, this is what I mean. Here, there's no way I could have dodged that. This is just a BS attack. This is just badly made. This is just a badly made attack, and yeah. If there was a little bit more delay for that attack, that you could see the shadow and try to get away, that would be a good attack, but the way it was made there, it was just terrible. So yeah, what's here? Here's another chance to get something, but not something very useful. Even if I got the Mr. Mega, or if I got the Steam Sale, or if I got Poison Touch, that really does not make a difference. Really doesn't. Maybe get some hearts or something. Really doesn't make a difference. This guy, he wants me, he's dead, thankfully. But yeah, this does not look very good, guys. We need a miracle right now. We need a true Christmas miracle. And since it's not Christmas, I'm not really holding my breath for a miracle. But sometimes one of these angels or whatever creature is responsible for miracles. They have their calendar all upside down. They think that today is Christmas, although it's not Christmas. And they will make a Christmas miracle happen, and we get the Mom's Knife and lots of Spirit Hearts. But really, just a few Spirit Hearts and Mom's Knife and I would be set. Just something to give me more killing power, really. This is really all I need. All I need in this life, and then it's me and my Mom's Knife! Rainbow Baby. You're so funny, game. You're so funny. Yeah, but in case you don't know, Rainbow Baby is just another familiar that shoots random tears, and I'm stupid, apparently. And this is pretty much not what we need, or it is what we need, but it's not good enough. It is not good enough, and this guy shoots, why not kill him, hopefully get him. I mean, and the thing is, we have Guppy's tail. We have Guppy's tail, but we got several golden chests, but not the items in the golden chest that we need. And it's not my fault. I've played as well as I can, but if I get these three items, that's not really something I can do about it. So boom, open this one up, and then we go straight to our deaths. Go straight to our deaths. Go straight down there to our death. Maybe there's still a miracle and we can still defeat them. I have no way to survive any hit. So at least, but now I'm slowing. And slowing is actually quite powerful. The only reason you would ever want to take the Rainbow Baby is sometimes it can shoot slowing tears, and these are Little Gish's tears. And Little Gish, of course, being the best familiar. Of course, if you don't consider a relic a familiar, which it really isn't, it is not a familiar, it's a weird item. A good item, but it's not a familiar. So yeah, this guy is slowed, and the slowing effect is actually very powerful. Look at the damage I've already done. I have not yet been hit. So yeah, but there are all these tears coming in. So much potentially, and I only got one orbital. And there are so many tears everywhere. How can I dodge all of them? This is bullet hell. This is bullet hell right here. Okay. Oh man, this is gonna be painful. I will fight, of course, to the last life. Yeah, but you see, I've slowed him down again. The slowing down effect is actually very powerful. If I had all the spirit hearts and the half heart interval that I started with, then Look at this, I have almost killed them. They are almost dead, they are less than half life. But now there are so many flies, they are following me. What am I supposed to do? What am I supposed to do? And I take the chariot, place a bomb, but I can't get out. It won't let me out. I'm stuck. What on earth? I was stuck, I couldn't move there. Come on, die you pieces. Die please. Come on. Almost got it, but there are so many flies. This is not good. And both get hit. No, only one gets hit. And oh. Man, this is so close. This is actually so close. And I have got to get them both in loop, but this loop will break. And he's frozen. He is actually frozen. Oh yes. He's dead. Oh yes. Come on. You die, please. You die. Okay. Gotcha. And now this chest contains another familiar. Yeah, why not? We did anyway. Oh yes. After so much fighting and after so much effort, now we get this room and we are really dead. This is just no beating around the bush. This is death and this is pestilence and there's just no way. No way. I right now have a snowball's chance in hell. There's not even a snowball's chance in hell. I'm dead. This is it, guys. Hope you enjoyed the run anyway. We got what we came for. We got the bloody penny. And this is our last life. And we will get totally destroyed and raped and mutilated by Death and his companion here. Yeah. But hopefully the next run will be a little more happier. I will get better items. I did all I could. I fought as hard as I could. Hopefully this run, as I said, has brought you some joy. Hopefully. But right now, this is just it. And I'll see you guys for next episode. Bye-bye.